Well, obviously, this year we have like two matches at home and three matches away, and we receive England and Scotland at Rome. And obviously, for us, every single match we play at home, we want to target to win. But we really know as well that we can lose easily against England, and we can lose against Scotland as well if you play at home. So it's going to be difficult, even if we play against them at home. But the idea for the team is obviously get 100% and be regular all the tournament. But you know, for me personally, we want to separate the Six Nations in two parts. The first part is the first two matches, and we play two sides as France and England that have new coaches, new expectation. Maybe you know teams that want to you know winning the tournament because they have really poor World Cup both nations. So obviously, for us. And for our point of view, with a lot of injuries, with a team with not much too many experience, we must try to build confidence from these matches. Whatever the result is, trying to play the best as we can against these two nations. And after that, we're gonna receive Scotland at Rome, and we're gonna go into Cardiff and in Dublin again. So maybe in the second part of the Six Nations, we're gonna get back in the team a couple of players who are not fit enough to play the first two matches. And obviously, if you play well the first two matches against big teams, you're going to build confidence for the team for the rest of the championship. When you perform well, even if you don't win, but you perform well, you have continuity, you are regular. But we were a team in the few years that we're doing like great results. Maybe like beating France twice, who anyone expect, or win one time Ireland, be a couple of times Scotland in the past. But after that, we maybe take the weekend after, we take 40 points, or we play a really, really poor match. So yeah, I think in terms of quality, in terms of how we play, how we want to play, in terms of the what we do in the past, we deserve to continue to play this tournament. This is my opinion, own opinion. Obviously, you don't much to agree with that. And I know there are a lot of people that don't agree with me, but I doesn't care. That is my opinion, because when I play the matches and I play against the team in the field, I feel that you can beat them or put them under pressure. I don't feel we are like 100 minutes away of them. But obviously, when you play international level, there are little details that make you a good team and a big team. And obviously, today we know we are not a good team, we're not a big team. We know we have a lot of weakness, but a lot of strengths. And the only way that we can be competitive and maybe sometimes can make good results is to play 100% and trying to, you know, be really focusing these little details every single match. It's not easy. That is the difference between big teams and teams as Italy. But this is our job, our objective every single year before playing this tournament. The Six Nations is really, from the physical point of view, really intense. So obviously, I don't gonna play this weekend with Stade Français. So for me, it's gonna be good to have a weekend off and recover well to the first match against France. For me personally, it was a difficult moment in the Six Nations. I just got injured the last warm-up match against Wales, and I missed the first three matches, first two matches, and just be not fit enough. But I played 60 minutes against Ireland. Now it's completely different. I feel really well. Play with Stade Français the last four matches and 80 minutes, and I feel really, really, really good to start the Six Nations. Well, I think he spent 4 years in Italy, and you know, it's not easy for any coach to coach the Italian team, because you must know that you have not too many facilities, and you don't have like 40, 50 players the high level. So was difficult for Jacques, but I think he really gave a lot in these 4 years. And obviously, in the last season was difficult for everyone. And obviously, when you are coach, you are criticized. And obviously, Jacques, especially in Italy, criticized a lot for the performance of the team. At the moment, unfortunately, there are like 13 players who've been involved in the last World Cup who are off for the first two matches, especially for injuries. So it's the opportunity for 10 uncapped players to be part of the squad. So, we're going to have a squad with a lot of players with not too much experience at the international level. So starting against France in Paris and England at Rome is going to be a really tough beginning of the Six Nations for us. But at the same time, it's an opportunity to use these players, to improve, to play, to get experience and, to start playing international level. And have you seen the last 10 years, we don't find a fly half who play, much than 2-3 years with the number 10 jersey. And this year, for the Six Nations in the last World Cup, was Tommaso Allan and Carlo Canna with this responsibility. Unfortunately, Tommaso Allan is trying to get fit maybe for the second part of the tournament, but we're going to start with Carlo Canna and Padovani, who is another young Italian player who plays in Zebre, who is performed well. So, still young players, you must to learn and improve. But I think, especially for looking forward for the next World Cup, that it's good to them to play matches, important matches as we play in this tournament. And they're going to have a lot of pressure, of sure. But I think for Carlo Canna and even for Padovani, it's a really good chance to get involved in the national team and to show that they have the quality to play. So hopefully for them, they perform well. Well, yes, Kelly, actually, I think he's not in the last months, he don't play too much. Or I think maybe he's going to play this weekend as well with Zebre. And he's able to play 10 or 12. After that, this is coach's decision, obviously, to make it. But, we have Padovani and Canna, they really 10. And Aimona, who can play 10 and 12 as well. And, after that, it's going to be Jacques' decision to who gonna play with the 10 jersey, who gonna play center. This 10 uncapped player, there are three players who played the domestic championships. Obviously, the results. Calvisano take 12 tries in Cardiff, and when you get that result, it's really difficult to keep forward, especially from the mental point of view of the players. But that's just another story. Now they are with the national team, and obviously, imagine when you are young, when you arrive in the national team with no caps, you want to show, you have a lot of energy, a lot of, and I'm really looking forward for them to give that to the team. We are like 4 or 5 players with a lot of experience, and we're going to try to help them. And we must build a team in less time. We have not too many time to prepare the Six Nations as the other nations, especially us with 10 young players, and especially 10 uncapped players, they're going to play for sure in the first two matches. So it's going to be difficult, that is the truth. And the idea is to try to build confidence. And you can build confidence if you perform well. And as Italian team, we know we are realistic, that we are I don't know if the weak team in the tournament, but we are not the team we're going to win the Six Nations. We are a team who every year, even if we beat Scotland 1 year, even if we beat sometimes, happens to beat France twice in the last 4 years, or beat Ireland one time. Every single year, people ask if we deserve to play this tournament. So every single year, we must show that we really deserve to play. And the only way you can be credible as a team is perform well. But from our point of view, we know it's going to be really, really difficult to get victories in the first two matches against France and in England. But as I said before, we're trying to build confidence in these two matches, playing two big nations, and trying to continue to perform well and target maybe a victory after the match against Scotland at Rome and the two matches away. So it's not easy, and every single match you must play, you never know. If you are lucky, we can beat France. But obviously, it's no way that I arrive here and say we're going to beat France next week. Obviously, as captain, especially with these 10 uncapped players who are involved in the squad, my my job is to try to, you know, to help them and trying to, you know, give them confidence. And you know, there are a lot of pressure when you play an international test match, especially a competition like the Six Nations. So the most part of this guy never play in stadium like Stade de France or Millennium. And, you know, it's a lot of pressure for the young players, a lot of pressure for the players who never be involved in international tests. So you obviously as captain, I want trying to, you know, you know, just focus in rugby. It's a rugby match, and try to help them to manage all these pressures around them. Obviously, especially in the first matches, playing against France and England with two new coaches and new captains. So, you know, for us, for our point of view, it's not like a weakness for France or a weakness for England to, you know, starting or playing against us with new coaches, new captains. I think the inverse, I think they're going to be really exciting to play. I think Guirado is going to be really excited to show everyone he deserves to lead the French team. The same thing for Dylan. I think he's really criticized apparently for everyone to be captain, and he has the opportunity, and I think he want to show to Eddie Jones, for all his teammates, all his country, he deserves to be the captain. So no, I think it's going to be an extra motivation for them. So for us, unfortunately, it's going to be no good news. Well, you know, I don't know all the Dylan lies, and I obviously hear how everyone here that they have a couple of problems and stuff. But I think a player and a person, we can learn about our mistakes, and you have in life the opportunity, you know, every time to maybe, you know, show that you learn really of this maybe mistake. And for Dylan, it's a big opportunity. I'm not here to give lessons to anyone to how lead a team. I just lead in my team as I think is the best thing to lead. And you know, it's important as captain just to perform well in the field, leading by example. And I think, and I hear Dylan in the conference trying to give this message. And I think he's a really good hooker, and he wanna try to perform well better. After that, how you can manage your relationship with the coach, with the players, with your teammates, with the press, that is something that you must to manage as captain, and trying to, you know, knowing that we are captain, you must make decision. You're going to be under pressure, and obviously you must be responsible of your decision. That is what is be captain is not easy, but at the same time, and no, especially when you captain a nation as England. It's great because obviously every single year you have teams, you maybe make like good results. I don't know, I take us last year, we go in Scotland with a lot of young players. We have like two uncapped players play in the first matches, and in Italy everyone say you're never going to beat Scotland at Murrayfield, and everyone expect us to win, and we're doing a good result. Years before, there are teams that they doing great campaigns. It's exciting because from my point of view, and even for the Italian point of view, it's great to go in to play in Cardiff at Millennium Stadium, or go into Ireland, you know, see all the support, all the atmosphere around the international matches. It's different. It's different, the Six Nations, compared with, I don't know, when you go in June playing in New Zealand, Australia. It's another atmosphere. The Six Nations, you live really, you know, it's really exciting because everyone is really looking forward for going to the ground, you know, see the matches, and it's really exciting as players to play. So, you know, obviously we are really lucky, and we must enjoy, because I'm 32 years old. I don't know how many years I'm going to still play, and so I want to keep all these good moments to, you know, good moments to feel and to play as a player for the rest of my life.